This is the seventh part of Amazon EKS tutorial. In this section, we'll talk about Nginx Ingress Controller. First, let's take a look at the high-level architecture. When you install Nginx Ingress Controller in your cluster, it also creates a layer 4 network load balancer in the cloud. This load balancer will be used to route every single request sent to your application using this particular Ingress class. The network load balancer does not understand HTTP protocol and will not terminate TLS. It will pass everything to the Nginx controller itself. When you create Ingress object to expose your application, that object is parsed and converted by the controller into the native Nginx configuration. So when a request comes from the load balancer, Nginx will act as a reverse proxy and, based on the routes defined in Nginx, route the request to your specific application. Since we'll use AWS load balancer controller to create network load balancer for the Nginx Ingress controller, we'll use IP mode. This means AWS will not use node ports and add all your Kubernetes workers to the target group. Instead, it will use Nginx controller pod IP addresses only in the target group. This helps avoid some limitations, removes additional network hop, and increases performance. So I suggest installing AWS load balancer controller before deploying Nginx Ingress controller. Now, since we have a middleman such as Nginx proxy, we can collect many metrics for each destination application without additional effort. You can scrape Nginx Prometheus metrics and create dashboards with latency, request per second, availability, and other metrics. I have another video that explains how to monitor any application that uses Nginx Ingress controller. In large companies, it's very common to deploy a public-facing Ingress controller that uses external load balancer with a publicly routable IP. You would use that Ingress to expose client-facing applications. On the other hand, you would deploy another Nginx Ingress controller with only a private load balancer. This load balancer will get a private IP that is only routable within your VPC. You would use it for your internal services as well as internal dashboards such as Grafana. We frequently use this type of Ingress with private Route 53 hosted zones and client VPNs for the dashboards. I'll create additional video explaining how to use private Ingress with private DNS and client VPN to securely expose dashboards only within your team. Another benefit that not many people know is that you can use Nginx Ingress controller to route custom TCP and UDP services. Usually, we would expose them with a service of type load balancer, resulting in as many load balancers as you have services. Nginx Ingress controller allows sharing a single load balancer to expose all your custom services. This is mostly used because load balancers have hourly charges. So by limiting the number of load balancers, you reduce the cost of your infrastructure. I also have a video explaining how to do this using Nginx config map. In the majority of cases, you want to secure your application's HTTP endpoint with a TLS certificate. It is possible to provide your own certificate and private key to the Nginx as a Kubernetes secret, but in most cases, we want to automate this process. To automate, we deploy additional component called Cert-Manager. It integrates with Nginx Ingress via annotations and automatically obtains and renews your certificates. If it fails to renew the certificate, you'll get a warning via email from Let's Encrypt ahead of time, giving you a chance to debug and fix the issue. To obtain certificate, Cert-Manager uses a custom resources. First, it creates a certificate and checks if you already have a certificate for the domain. If not, it creates a certificate request custom resource. Behind the scenes, it generates a private key and stores it in Kubernetes secret. Then, Cert-Manager will create another custom resource called an order. Finally, the order custom resource will create a challenge. There are two main challenges that you can use. HTTP01 is the simplest one to configure. Cert-Manager will obtain a secret token from Let's Encrypt and expose it on a custom path on your domain. Then, Let's Encrypt will verify it and issue a certificate. Another challenge, DNS01, is a little bit more complex to configure because you need to grant Cert-Manager IAM permissions to create TXT records in Route 53. However, it is preferred in production because it allows you to get a certificate even before routing and changing live DNS to point to the Nginx Ingress load balancer. With DNS 01 challenge, Cert-Manager will get the same secret token, but to prove that you own the domain, Cert-Manager needs to create custom TXT records. When Let's Encrypt can query your domain and verify those records, you'll get a certificate. Certificates are valid for 90 days, but approximately every 60 days, Cert-Manager will try to renew them. There are two main reasons for the short expiration on the certificate. If the certificate is compromised, attackers would have a limited amount of time to cause damage. Another reason is that short interval forces you to automate this process instead of manually updating certificates. I have another lesson explaining how to debug both DNS and HTTP 01 challenges. Alright, let's create all necessary components to deploy Nginx Ingress controller. It doesn't need any permissions on AWS side. One of the most common deployment methods is to use Helm. So let's use open source Helm chart and override a few variables. Let's create Nginx Ingress.yaml file. In the past, we had to use both the Ingress class and the legacy annotation so that Cert-Manager could create Ingress to validate HTTP 01 challenge. This is no longer necessary after Cert-Manager was updated to use Ingress class name property as well. Usually, you would have external ingress that exposes applications to the internet as well as internal ingress with private DNS to expose some internal dashboards, such as Grafana or even Prometheus. So let's give this ingress the class name external Nginx. Then we can configure the load balancer that we want. We'll use AWS load balancer controller to create a network load balancer for the Nginx Ingress because we want to use IP mod. I covered everything related to AWS load balancer controller in the previous section. Finally, we want this load balancer to have a publicly routable IP address. That's pretty much all for the deployment. Let's go ahead and run Terraform. Now, let's get the service. Nginx Ingress will use this load balancer for each application that you configure with this ingress. You will always want to create a CNAME record with a value pointing to this load balancer. By default, it exposes only ports 80 and 443. There are some options to expose custom TCP and UDP services using a single load balancer, which is useful for those who want to save on load balancer hourly charges. As you can see, it's a network load balancer and it's public. Let's wait until it's active. Let's also open the target group to make sure it uses IP mod and routes traffic directly to the Nginx Ingress controller. Let's also wait until the controller shows up as healthy in the console before testing anything. So this is Nginx Ingress controller port IP address. If you get more replicas, you get more IPs here. You can see that IP of the pod matches the IP in the target group. The load balancer will always route traffic to your application through Nginx Ingress pod, because all the logic is inside Nginx, not in the load balancer, like with AWS load balancer controller. After deploying Nginx Ingress, we have the second Ingress class, external Nginx. The first one we used in previous section. Now, let's go ahead and test. For the first example, we'll use a simple deployment object with a service cluster IP. For the Ingress, we'll use a simple Ingress resource that routes traffic based on the host header in the request. You can keep this host because we're not going to create a DNS record. We'll use curl and provide the host to test. For the next Ingress, you will need to create a DNS record. Also, to use Nginx Ingress, just use Ingress classname property and match the service and the port number. Alright, let's apply it. Let's get the Ingress. it may take a minute or so to populate the address section. You can wait or just create a CNAME pointing to the load balancer. It's going to be the same value. Let's get the ingress one more time, and now we have the address. This ingress only uses HTTP protocol and port 80. Now, to test it locally without creating a DNS record, you can pass the host header to curl, and the following argument will be the load balancer hostname. Alright, it looks like it works, and we get the version back for our application. By the way, the source code for this app is in the repository as well. It's a very simple Go application. Alright, let's delete this namespace with all resources. For the next example, to use HTTPS and issue a certificate from Let's Encrypt, we need to additionally install Cert-Manager. In this lesson, we'll use HTTP/01 challenge to prove ownership. In one of the previous videos on how to debug ingress, I covered both DNS and HTTP challenges and which one you should use in production. We'll use a Helm chart as well to deploy it to our cluster. Cert-Manager uses custom resources to automatically obtain and renew certificates, so we need to install them during the deployment. Alright, let's apply Terraform. Let's get the pods to verify that all of them are running. Now, for this example, we need to create a cluster issuer that you can use in all namespaces to obtain certificates. You need to update email so that if Cert-Manager fails to renew a certificate, you get a warning ahead of time. Also, for this lesson, we'll use HTTP/01 resolver and use our ingress to resolve those challenges. Take a note of the name property. We'll use it in the ingress annotation to reference this issuer. Then we have the same deployment and the service objects. Finally, the ingress. First of all, we want to use our Cert-Manager cluster issuer for this ingress. To secure this ingress with HTTPS, we need additional TLS section. You should include all DNS names that you want to use and the secret name within this namespace for the certificate and the private key. It will be automatically mounted to the Nginx ingress controller, enabling it to terminate TLS and route requests to your application. That's all, let's apply it. Now it's time for me to show you how to debug ingress. First, we need to check if the certificate is ready. As you can see, this one is not. So the next step would be to describe it. You'll find that certificate created certificate request custom resource, which behind the scenes generated a private key and stored it in the Kubernetes secret specified in the ingress resource. Let's go ahead and describe that certificate request. Certificate request created another custom resource called order. Let's describe that as well. The order created the last custom resource that we need to investigate, which is called challenge. In our case, it's HTTP/01 challenge. Let's describe it. Here you can see the problem. We created the ingress, but never created a DNS record so that Let's Encrypt can verify that we own this domain. Solution is very simple. We just need to create a CNAME record pointing to the Nginx ingress load balancer. But before that, let me show you a couple of things. Cert-Manager also created additional temporary ingress to expose the token provided by Let's Encrypt. Alright, let's create a CNAME record. You can do this with any DNS host provider. In my case, I use Route 53. This time, you need to use your own domain. The type will be CNAME and the value is the load balancer hostname. After you create a CNAME record, it may take a few minutes to obtain a certificate. So let's watch and wait. Alright, we have the certificate now. For the final check, let's verify in the browser that the connection is secure and we use the Let's Encrypt certificate. You can see we have the certificate, which is valid for 90 days, and approximately every 60 days, Cert-Manager will try to renew it automatically. If it fails for some reason, you'll get a warning at the email address you used to create cluster issuer. All right, that's all. Let's clean up. In the next section, we'll talk about how to run stateful applications in EKS and use CSI driver to allocate EBS volumes and mount them to the pods with read-write-once access mode.